more in person. And some of you all might be night people. But I know when I began to, God pressed on my heart, when I truly got a relationship with God and I really wanted to pray, and I tried to do it at nighttime. And when I would go in, I would just almost fall asleep. And all of a sudden, God said to me one morning, one night, he said, don't pray at nighttime. Pray in the morning. So I began to start praying in the morning. And I'll tell you, that was my place.
Praise the Lord.
And then I found out later, and I began to read where it says in Psalm, it says, and I think that was the brother Meshach, and Billy, that they got up, they prayed, what, three times a day? And they got up early in the morning.
Early.
And I believe that God, and even Jesus got up early in the morning. I believe that God wants us to seek him first.
Yes.
Seek him first, early in the morning. Seek him first, early in the morning. Praise God. We need to come to God, discipline ourselves to come to God. Choose your time. Choose your time when you want to come to God. But you got to meet him. It's best to meet him at the same time on the same day. That's what I have found that really works for me. It's to discipline yourself. If you don't have a prayer life right now, discipline yourself that I'm going to go in and I'm going to pray at the same time every day. So you make sure that it will not get away from you. Praise God. Now, that does not mean that some days you might, some things might go on and you might miss. But you don't want to miss three or four days.
No.
You want to come to God, what? Every day.
Yeah.
As much as possible to build a relationship. But we've got to what? We've got to discipline ourselves to do that.
Yes.
And sometimes your flesh is not going to want to do that.
Uh-huh.
It's going to want to lay there and sleep some more. It's going to want to lay there and say, I'm tired. I don't feel like doing it. But God tells us that we are to walk by faith and not by what how we feel it. Praise God.
Amen.
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 Thank you for saying amen. Nobody else says amen, I say amen too.
Amen.
So now I would like for us to look at, and if you're worrying about how fast I'm going to finish here, I have about 4 points, and then I'll be finished. So these are some more admonitions that we need to go along with prayer. And so let's turn to Matthew 6 and 5. Matthew 6 and 5. Matthew 6 and 5. It says, but when you pray, go into your room, close the door, and pray to the Father who is unseen.
Mm-hmm.
Then your Father who sees what is done in secret will reward you.
Amen.
Now here he's telling you that now we're praying what? Individually.
Mm-hmm. All right.
And he did not say if you pray. So God is assuming that what? We're all going to do what? We're all going to pray. Praise God. Now let's look at verse 6. And when you pray, do not keep on babbling. Like the pagan, for they think that they will be heard because of their many words.
Uh-huh.
Now, here he's saying here that it's not just you praying by yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And he says, when you pray, when you pray right here, you're praying with other people.
Because
he's telling you don't keep going on and on when you're with other people.
Mm-hmm.
And so that means that when your church calls for prayer, we need to be there.
Yeah.
Praise God. Now let's go on and look at verse 9 right here. And I think I'm in the wrong one here. Oh, I just need to scroll down. Okay, verse 9. This then is how you should pray. And this prayer right here, and I'm not going to go through the whole thing right here. But this is not per se for us to just to say this, but it is a model for us to go by.
Yes.
So when we're praying. So here the model says, our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come, your will be done. How are you going to know what God's will is to be done? What is God's will? How are you going to know God's will? You got to know the word. Because he has in his word what his will is. So therefore, you're going to have to what? Stay in the word.
Yeah.
To know what God's will is. You got to know that it is God's will for us to prosper and be in good health. That's what he said. That's his will.
Amen.
You got to know that his will is for all to be saved and come into the knowledge of truth. You got to know that. Because these are his words. Because otherwise, we're going to put our own little what in will in.
Mm-hmm.
But he wants his what? His what will to be done.
Amen.
And so how that's how we're going to know. We're going to know because we got to study the word.
Amen.
So, and along with prayer, one of the ammunitions that we need is that we need God's word. And God has made it so easy for us now. We can even get the word on our phone. Yeah. And then he made it so easy right now, we don't even have to read it. We can just listen to it.
That's right.
Amen. Praise God. We can even just go on our computer. I mean, the word is just making the words just so easy for us right now.
Amen.
So God wants us to do what? He wants us to stay in the word. Praise God. He don't want us to be so busy that we can't stay in the word. Because even if you're washing dishes, you can have what? Word on.
Yeah.
Listening to the word. Praise God. So God wants us to stay in the word. And then I'm going to go through the rest of it. Even in the rest of this, the Lord's Prayer, how will you know, it says, give us this day. What's the day of grace? You got to know that God's not going to supply your need. You got to know that.
Amen.
You got to know that he's going to lead you not into temptation. That he's always going to, God said in his word that I'm going to always give you a way to escape.
Yeah.
So you got to know his will.
Yeah,
so we got to stay in his word. Praise God. Now, the other weapon that we want look at is in verse 14. Looking at verse 14. For if you forgive others, people, when they sin against you, your heavenly Father will also forgive you.
Yes.
But if you do not forgive others their sin, your Father will not forgive you of your sin.
All right.
So we got to forgive because that's one way that we can hinder our what? We can hinder our prayer.
Yeah.
Praise God. We can hinder God from being doing what? Bound to do something when we pray. So we don't want a hindrance in our prayer.
Uh-huh.
So we got to forgive. Now, the next one is a real bad word here. Because we're still right here in the same chapter right here. And the next one says, when you fast, we don't want to hear that, dude, because we don't want to give up that what? We don't want to give up that plate.
Mm-hmm.
But he says, when you fast, do not look forward as the hypocrites do, so that they disfigure their faces to show others that they are fast.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, when we pray, God said in Mark 9:29, he says, and this kind.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to have some this kind.
Yeah, come on.
You're going to have some this kind.
Yeah.
That's going to come in your life.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you're going to have to what? Give up the appetite for a minute or two.
Uh-huh.
All right.
And don't be afraid of fasting. Because there are all types of fasts that you can go through.
Yes.
There are fasts where you don't talk. You just want to, many times you can give up a food where you just give up something that you really, really like.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And then if you like to not to even eat anything, it's up to you. You can drink something. So there are all types of, there's a Daniel fast.
Yeah.
I know that we, my church and I, we just have gone through a Daniel fast. And I'll tell you what, there was something that bound to happen in that Daniel fast.
Yes, yes.
Praise God. And if I get to it, I'll come back to that. Praise God. But God says, when you fast, he said, when you fast. He didn't say if you fast.
When.
But he said what?
When
you fast.
Yeah.
Eli. Just don't stop just for a minute. Because somebody needs a breakthrough.
Yeah.
Somebody needs a breakthrough in something.
Yeah.
Yes. And I just came by to tell you today. God is saying to us today.
Amen.
Pray and fast. Because this kind.
This kind.
I don't know what your kind is. But this kind.
Mm-hmm.
will only come out through prayer and fast.
Yes.
Amen. Now here is my last one. It looks like I got about 10 more minutes. I'm going to use my 30 minutes. Praise God. Pastor. here's the last one here. The last one, as we said, this guy will come out through prayer and fast. And now I want to go to the theme of scripture. Let's go to the theme of scripture, which is Matthew 21:19. This scripture here, we're going to be talking about faith. And first, I want to give you a definition for faith, and I know that most everybody probably knows it, but I'm going to repeat it anyway. And the definition is that it's found in Hebrews 11:1. Praise God. And he says, faith is the confidence in what we hope for, the assurance about what we do not see.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you got to have that confidence. You got to have that confidence and hope. Hope, what is hope? Hope is expecting something.
Mm-hmm.
You expect it. What are you expecting now? What are you expecting right now? Some things that you can't even see, but you want God to do something.
Yeah.
And if you want God to do something, you got to expect God to do that.
Yeah,
by faith. And you got to set yourself like flint, and you got to stay there and don't move.
Uh-huh.
I don't care how the situation look. You can't move. Don't move off of it. Because you got to have the assurance, that blessed assurance, to know that God is going to do this thing.
Yeah.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Matthew 21:19. Now seeing a fig tree by the road,
mm-hmm.
he went up and found nothing on it except leaves. Then he said to it, "May you never bear fruits again." Uh-huh. Immediately the tree withered. When the disciples saw this, they were amazed. How did the fig tree wither so quickly? They asked. Jesus replied, "Truly I tell you, if you have faith and do not die, not only can you do what was done to this fig tree, but also you can say to the mountain,
uh-huh.
go throw yourself into the sea, and it will be done." Uh-huh. If you will.
Believe.
If you believe.
Yes.
If you believe.
Uh-huh.
You will receive whatever you ask in prayer.
Uh-huh. Amen, amen.
But you got to believe. You got to have faith. God.
Amen.
To know that God is able to do what he says he's able to do.
Yes.
Praise
Amen.
God. And I want to go back to his word. And then I'm going to just do a few closing words in a few minutes here. But you got to know what God's will is. You can't be praying. But you got to believe whatever you pray for. And it has to be aligned with what?
The word of God.
If you do something, it's bound to happen. You know, some of us, we're really good at quote scripture.
Uh-huh.
We're really good at praying real smooth.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? We're really good at, some of us, we're up here preaching. But we have no faith at all.
Mm-hmm.
You know? He's given all of us a measure of faith. He
mm-hmm.
said, "I've given it to you as far as what? Mustard seed." All of us got some faith on the inside of us. Praise God. God wants, he's looking for a man or a woman of God that's going to have some faith in him. And no matter how things look,
mm-hmm.
no matter what they look like, he's saying to stand on the faith that I have given you. Don't give up. He said, don't give up. Don't give up. Praise God. Because when you pray, something is bound to happen. Now, I just want to take just a few minutes here. I have 5 minutes, and I plan to be finished in 5 minutes here. My husband, which has gone on to be with the Lord, became my pastor and my husband. When I first met my husband, I thought he was a casual drinker. But as time went on, I found out that my husband was an alcoholic. And as we were married, it seemed like it got worse and worse. Praise God. But I tell you, and I'm so appreciative of that time, because I tell you, that caused me to get on my knees.
Yes, amen.
And stay on my knees.
Amen.
Praise God. And I'm not going to tell you it was finished with in a couple of months. I'm not going to tell you it was finished with in a couple of days, a couple of months, and not even a couple of years. This thing went on for 10 or 15 years.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
God, every time I'd go someplace, I'd be crying. Pray for my husband, pray for my husband, pray for my husband. And one day God said, you pray for your husband.
All right. Amen. Amen.
You pray. You pray for your husband. And I began to pray. Then I also began to read God's word.
Yes.
Amen.
Because I was praying, God, just let him come off. Let him come off alcohol. Let him come off that. Don't let him be drinking. Don't let him be drinking. But I got a hold of God's word. And I stood on it. I'm not telling anybody to stand on this. You can let God give you a word.
Yes, yes.
I tell you, I stood on it. Colossians 1, 9 through 13.
Amen.
I say, God, I don't know when, but I know you're going to do it.
Amen. Yeah, beautiful, beautiful.
I don't know when, but I know you're going to do it.
Mm-hmm.
And I stuck with it because I said, I believe you, God. I believe your word. And I'm going to stand on it. I don't care what I see with these eyes. I don't care how much he goes out and drink. I don't care how much he steals my money and get him a drink. I don't care. Stand on the word.
Amen.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
My prayer is today that you stand on the word.
Amen.
Praise God. And continue to believe that God is able to do what he says he's able to do.
Yes, he
is. Now, I just want to just mention just a few things, and Apostle Barbara, you can be prepared to come on up here just for a minute. This verse, it said, Jesus replied, truly I tell you, if you have faith and do not doubt, not only can you do what was done to the fig tree. And that's what Jesus said. I'm not saying it. Not only you can do what he did with the fig tree, but also you can say to the mountain.
Amen.
Yeah.
Go throw yourself into the sea. Well, I don't know what your mountain is today. But God is saying, you can speak to that thing.
Yes, amen.
Amen.
And it will be done.
Yes.
If you believe.
Yes.
You will receive.
Come on now.
You are going to receive.
Amen.
Believe God.
Hallelujah.
And don't go keep going along and say, this thing, I tried this thing for so many days, it ain't going to work.
Amen.
But I tell you, you stay with it. Stay with it. Praise God.
Amen.
This verse is not guaranteed that we get anything that we want simply because we ask for Jesus and believe. I'm going to say this again. Hear me now. This verse is not a guarantee that we can get anything we want simply because we're asking Jesus and believe. God does not grant requests that would hurt us or even hurt others. Because somebody, I don't know, somebody might be saying, God, just get rid of me. I want to just get rid of myself right now. No, he's not going to answer that.
No.
God does not grant requests that would hurt us or others, or what would violate his what? His own nature or his will. He's not going to violate his will.
Yeah.
Jesus' statement is not a blank check. Mm-hmm. That we can just write anything that we want in that check. To be fulfilled, our request must be in harmony with the principles of God's kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. And he's left us some direction. The stronger I believe, the more likely our prayers will be in line with God's will.
Amen.
And when God will happen, then God will be happy to grant us his will.
Mm-hmm.
He'll be happy to grant us his will. if we are in line with what? His will.
Amen.
His will.
Amen.
And not your will.
Yeah.
Praise God.
Amen.
His will.
His will.
And not your will. Praise Amen. God. So, Father, we thank you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Thank we thank you, Lord God,
thank
that you've given us a chance
yes, yes,
to fight in this war.
Yes, sir.
And we know something is bound to happen.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so, God, we pray today, if there be somebody who does not have a prayer life today, we pray, Lord God, from this day, they're going to begin to get into the war. They're going to be ready to fight for them. They're going to be ready to fight for the enemy when he comes to try to torment our mind. They're going to be ready to fight, Lord God, when he comes to try to destroy our children and to try to destroy our marriage. They're going to be able to get into the fight, Lord God.
Thank you, Jesus.
And know that they are winners because you won when you was at the cross.
Yes.
And we say, thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
We give you glory. We give you praise, Lord God.
Glory to God.
So we thank you. And when we, Lord God, when we get so weak and sometimes we forget about prayer, bring us back to us, Lord God.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Bring it back to us, Lord God.
Lord,
so
yes,
we can get close to you, Lord God.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
Hallelujah.
Lord. Yes, Lord.
And not give up. Don't let us faint.
Yes, Lord.
Because you are not a God that you are lying. Satan is a liar, but you're not a God that you're going to lie.
Yes.
You tell us the truth.
Yes.
And the truth is going to set us free. So God, we come in the name of Jesus. We say thank you.
Thank you.
We give you glory.
Thank
we give you praise for
yes,
in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.